Welcome to the Lunchbag Show, your exciting new midday link-up, coming to you live from the Northern Caribbean University studio in Mandeville, Jamaica. I'm your host, Ralna Simmons-Allen, and with me are my co-hosts, Tyreek Smith, Chanel Mills, and Chrisanne Hewitt.
Every week, we'll bring to you interesting stories and people from across the world.
All right, so guys, what does Lunchbag have to offer?
Lunchbag has features, interviews.
Lunchbag also has informative and fun information that I'm sure persons will gravitate to.
All right, so we have a great menu lined up just for you. But just before we go into the menu, let's check in with the time zone. So now that you know the time where you are in the world, and the time is money, let us talk about money matters.
But you know what's interesting about time and money? You can always get more money, but you can't get more time. Now it's time for our island chat. What's going on in the news lately?
Caribbean to have access to COVID-19 vaccine. The COVAX facility is aiming to invest in vaccine acceleration to secure 2 billion doses by the end of 2021. 18 Caribbean countries have signed so far, including Belize, Grenada, Haiti, St. Lucia, Jamaica, and Trinidad and Tobago. What have you noticed in the news, Tyreek?
So $2 billion in damages in Jamaica due to the heavy rainfalls over the past week. So bridges were damaged, leaving residents dislocated. Several roads across the islands are now impassable. And some of the parishes affected by the heavy rainfalls are St. Andrew, St. Anne, Kingston, and St. Thomas.
Wow, Harry.
So the heavy rainfalls have been affecting Jamaica, well, in a harsh way.
Indeed. I can attest to that because even in St. Elizabeth, where I live currently, I've seen where students are struggling with virtual learning. As you know, COVID-19 has us to be practicing that a lot, or it's become our new lifestyle. And amongst that, we have the rain now, which is a little bit over the top, but we have to do what we must, right?
It's absolutely incredible. And when you think about all the persons who would have lost their homes, they would have lost their property, they would have lost their livelihood, mm-hmm. and worst of all, for those who would have lost their lives.
Definitely.
That is so true. But on a brighter note, how would you like to visit a country virtually? Doesn't that sound interesting?
Definitely.
Yes, indeed. The tour goers were given the opportunity to visit Antigua and Barbuda to learn about the island's history, monuments, and hotspots. Interesting indeed. They also got to see how to make Caribbean cocktails and bread pudding. Tyreek, wonderful things happening.
That must be enjoyable. That must have been enjoyable.
Yes, indeed. Tourists immersed themselves in experience as many showed up to the virtual tour, in straw hats and sunglasses with a complimentary tropical drink. Now, I am very, very envious of them, honestly.
Most definitely.
You guys don't need to be envious, though. I mean, you can just think and plan for where you would want to visit. For example, I'm thinking about Switzerland. I like the sound of Switzerland. And I'm thinking about Finland as well, because I heard that Finland is the number one happiest country in the world. So I'd like to find out what's really going on over there.
You know what awesome I've realized stuff about the countries that you chose? They sound very rich. So whenever you're going, just pat me in that suitcase, you should be okay.
Definitely. But I think I would want to go to Bahamas, because Bahamas is so
tropical.
Exactly.
Nice.
And it has a nice vibe to it, you know, a nice island vibe to
That's
it.
That's right.
And now it's time to give you the lunch bag menu. These are the items on the menu.
On today's menu, we have shout outs from all over the world, features, and also some engaging music from a Caribbean artist, and more.
Also, there are some fascinating people who we will talk about podcasting, and also tell us what it is like to report live during a hurricane. I'm sure you don't want to miss that.
That's right, Tariq. And for all you men out there who want a great product for grooming your beards, we have that coming up too, so stick around.
That's right, guys. Coming up, we also have some great features for you with a touch of the Caribbean. Chrisanne, tell us about the features you have lined up.
We have some enjoyable features today. First up, Caribbeans tell us some bits and pieces about their native islands. How many of us don't like to ride in a fast car? Well, you're going to have to stick around for that. And capping up the features for today, are you tired of wearing your masks? Well, this feature will make you smile. We're going to take a quick break, but don't go away. Right after the break, we will have Mrs. Hanika Watkins Porter, an internationally recognized podcaster. So stay tuned.
Thank you for staying tuned to the Lunch Bag Show. We're coming to you from the Northern Caribbean University studio in Mandeville, Jamaica. Joining us today is Mrs. Hanika Watkins Porter, host of the Entrepreneurial You podcast, author and coach. Welcome, Mrs. Watkins Porter.
Oh, I am happy to be here. Thank you so much.
Nice having you. My first question to you, Mrs. Watkins Porter, is what opportunities are presently available for podcasters during this COVID crisis?
What? Say again?
What opportunities are presently available for podcasters during this COVID crisis?
Oh, first of all, it's actually a time now when podcasters can capitalize on the fact that people have a lot of downtime, a lot more downtime now than they ever did before. And so having that share of air is what we call it. Allowing people to spend time to consume your content. So it's a great opportunity. It's a great time for people now to get creative and put their content out, whatever it is that you are interested in. So whatever niche it is, whether you're in sports, education, entertainment, whatever it is, you have a passion, there is a space for you in the podcasting world.
Awesome stuff. All right, so you've been able to interview many big names on your business show over diverse industries. What is your secret for getting them to accept your interview?
Well, that's a secret. But in all seriousness, though, the important thing is crafting a message that puts the guest in the spotlight or the prospective guest in the spotlight. So it's not about me, hey, come on my show, I want you to talk on my show. But here are the reasons why you need to be on the show and how it will help you. Because everybody is tuned in to this radio station that is called WIIFM, What's in It for Me?
Right.
And so once you're able to sell that, you can sell ice to Eskimos if you know how to do it. So it's about crafting a message and allowing, you know, others to see the value that you're creating and how it's a win-win for both parties.
Incredible. I love that WIIFM idea. But yeah. In February, though, you shared on Instagram your number one ranking on Apple's podcast charts for Jamaica's entrepreneurship. So What do you think is fueling your success in entrepreneurship?
So they say an overnight success rather is 10 years in the making. And if I should go in, you know, go by mine, I would say 13 years in the making, because in 2007, that's when I really started entrepreneurship. And throughout that period, it has been a lot of trial and error, believe it or not, a lot of failing forward, a lot of, you know, just making mistakes. But for me, they were just experiences which, you know, allowed me to learn. And so fundamentally, what it is just that ability to stay the course no matter what. So obstacles will come, but sometimes you just got to pause, pivot, wheel and come again, as they say. And if ever a time that we're seeing how to wheel and come again is now in COVID, in this COVID crisis. So it's just, I think, my tenacity. Like I always say to persons that you can outskill me. You can be better than me because I don't think I'm the most skilled person. But what you can never outdo me on is perseverance, resilience, and just, you know, being tenacious and determined. You cannot outdo me on that. And so that is what, you know, because some of us, we quit too soon. Something didn't work out, you know, when we started. And instead of just, you know, re-examining where you are and wheeling and come again and having a new strategy, many people decided to quit. And, you know, people quit, a lot of people quit 3 feet from goal. If you get that, if you get an opportunity to read that book, it's an interesting read. A lot of people will quit 3 feet from goal. And literally what that is, you're just quitting too soon when you're just 3 feet away, 1 month away, 1 week away from your success.
Awesome. So you need to keep that drive. You have to keep that spirit and believe in the dream that you've got initially.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Incredible.
So, Mrs. Watkins Puerta, you just spoke about the keys of for having a successful podcasting program. I myself had thought about having a program, podcasting program. What three pieces of advice do you have for interesting and aspiring podcasters?
Okay, so number one is to understand your why. Like anything else you're doing, when you have a deep sense of why I'm doing what I'm doing, you know, Simon Sinek talks about, you know, that golden circle. So many people like to talk about what they do, but it's important to understand your why so that people buy into it. And not only that, when the tough gets going, because it will, there are days when you won't feel like going at anything that even the most passionate of person feel like quitting at times. I have felt like quitting many times. But when I look back on the reason I'm doing what I'm doing, then it propels me forward. So understand your why. That's very important. Understand that your commitment is important. Right. So don't just because it's easier now than ever to start a podcast, decide to start one. And then 2 months down the road, then there comes pod fade. You know, you start and then you just stop because the novelty has worn off and you're not as passionate about it anymore. So commitment is important. And thirdly, I would say be grounded in not just the idea of starting a podcast, but get a little more in on the foundations, you know? Just like you're starting anything, you start a business, you wouldn't just go start selling clothes, whatever it is that you're starting a business on. You'd find out, do the groundwork, you know, what's necessary for marketing, what is necessary for sales, everything that will come together. So get schooled on that. And whether it is that you're going to do your own research online or you're coming to a professional like myself to coach you on it, one-on-one coaching, or you're taking my course, or you're buying my book, Podcast Power, the Quick Start Guide to Launching and Leveling Up Your Brand, just get schooled because it's easier now more than ever to start a podcast, but it's also just as easy to quit if you don't have the foundations right.
Incredible.
Awesome stuff. Well, thank you so much for joining us, Mrs. Watkins Puerta, and thank you for sharing your expertise and your knowledge.
My pleasure, and I'm happy to be a part of this lunch bag.
Awesome stuff.
Awesome. All right, Chrisanne, over to you.
If you are anywhere on the 7 continents, anywhere at all, we want to hear from you. Take a look at these shoutouts. They are really putting lunch bag on the map.
This is Ricky Campbell saying hello from beautiful Ilmenau in Germany. And of course saying a special big up to Lunchbag and Northern Caribbean University.
A Assalamu alaikum from Qatar.
Hola, Ale, habla Saúl de Puerto Rico. Espero que todos estén bien, que se estén cuidando durante esta pandemia. Hi, it's Saúl speaking from Puerto Rico. Hope everybody's doing good, staying safe with this pandemic. Use your mask.
Hello guys, this is Rocky from London. As you can see, I'm in Paddington right now. The weather's lovely still. Big up all my Jamaicans, man. Most importantly, shout out Lunchbag Crew. All right guys, take care.
Hey everybody, this is Shem in London. I want to give a big shout out to everyone in Jamaica, especially the Lunchbag Crew. One love and keep safe again.
G'day, g'day, it's Samuel here from Brisbane, Australia, where the weather is always beautiful. Anyway, I just wanted to have a quick old hello to you people over there in Jamaica from the Lunch Break Show. Fantastic getting in touch with you.
It's a beautiful day in the Bronx, New York. Beautiful, sunny. Andre saying good morning to the Lunch Bar crew. Are you on the thing? Blessed love. Peace and love.
And we are back on the Lunch Bag Show. Our next guest is a YouTuber and former Caribbean correspondent and producer recognized for her accomplishments in the Anguillian media industry. Let help me welcome Miss Dupuy.
Hello, such a pleasure to be here. Thank you so much.
It's so good to have you, Miss Dupuy. How did you know that television presenting was your passion?
Well, really, my passion is communicating with people. And what I found is that you can use different mediums. You can use a phone and record and broadcast that, and perhaps it'll end up on television. And really what matters is the impact that you're able to make, and I always will end up public speaking. So I was never afraid to go out and talk to people when I started working at a radio station. And that really fueled my passion and my interest in TV.
Wow, that is absolutely sensational.
Incredible. So with that in mind, what launched your career as a media practitioner?
So I would say my career began volunteering. I would do commentary during Carnival like Juve. It's a really fun time and it's a good time to try out being on radio. And so soon there was an opportunity for a radio broadcaster and I was like, yes, let's do this. But I already begun volunteering, so it was a natural fit. And then there was Hurricane Irma, Category 5 hurricane. She caused a lot of destruction in my island, and I was able to do reports on that and really share the story to bring as much attention as I could to Angola. After that, I did some reports I helped to produce, stories on Brexit and how that could have affected Angola. And then I started dabbling with YouTube. I thought it would have been good to interview people and about different social issues. And so that's what I do right now.
Okay.
Great stuff. As natural disasters like earthquakes and hurricanes or storms are becoming more frequent, especially as we've seen this year, what keeps you so committed to the job that you took the risk of reporting the 2017 Hurricane Irma, as you mentioned earlier, in Anguilla for international news outlets such as CNN and BBC?
Yeah, I did. Sorry, I didn't hear the question.
What made you take on the task of reporting the Hurricane Irma that took place in 2017, even though it was quite risky?
Yeah, it was risky. You know what? And I really comprehended the risk when I was there, when it was already too late.
Yeah.
But it was sort of the thing to do at my station if you could, if you had an interest. And I just thought that it would be good to go out and work. And my mom also worked that night. She's a nurse at the hospital. She went out to work. So we both went to work.
Wow.
then when I realized that the shutters were loosening and particles were flying through the window, that's when it really started to hit, okay, this could be serious. And then we get calls like, I'm in the room with a baby and we're losing like windows or a door, whatever it is, it's very scary and it's surreal.
Wow.
So you do it because you know that it's something that is important, and you show up and you work. But then that sometimes comes with risk.
For sure. So pretty much then for you, it became a matter of a call of duty. It was something you had to do at the time. All right.
Go ahead.
Okay. So in keeping with that, how did you feel knowing that your coverage was being shared on an international platform, for example, with CNN and BBC?
Yeah, well, you know what? I felt so sad because of the hurricane. Like, there was one life lost on India, but you know, for the Caribbean, there were more lives, and even after that, the hurricane. So it's definitely really heart-moving images. And at the same time, there is a level of responsibility and pride when it comes to still representing the island properly.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. Awesome. So you have a YouTube channel that has highlighted some pretty sensitive issues happening in the society. What gives you the courage and the drive to explore these issues and to bring them to the public's attention?
Yeah, sometimes I scare myself with the topics that I choose. I'll tell you this, for example, I interviewed a woman who was an ex-prostitute, and she's now reformed, she's now a Christian. But that story alone, although I was never able to release it, was probably one of the most difficult interviews that I've ever done. You're speaking to a woman about her body and representation as a woman and how she went from one extreme to the other. And the stories are very moving. So you have to just really, you have to know your why. Why do I want to create this content? Like, who is it going to help? And so I think about that when I'm thinking about doing a story. And once you do that, then you're a lot more motivated to just go for it. I have to tell you, I cried during that interview. I cried after that interview. And there are some stories like that. For example, Kimberly Dawkins, who was sexually abused at 8. Like, the content sometimes, it's a bit scary, but you have to dig deep and know that it's a worthy discussion worth having. And some people need to know that they're not alone.
Thank you so much for sharing. And we do wish you the absolute best as you continue in your pursuit, as you continue in your profession. We thank you for your work. That was an insightful interview, but let's check Chrisan out. Chrisan, what good stuff have you got to share with us now?
Well, we are going to hear from people in the Caribbean with our Caribbean Vox Pop. Here we go.
My name is Andre Thornhill.
Yes, my name is Everett.
My name is Daniel Richard.
My name is Amelia.
My name is Adiba. I am from the beautiful country of Belize.
I am from the beautiful, 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 beautiful island of Cuba.
I am from Barbados.
I am from the beautiful country of Belize.
What makes my country unique, first of all, is the accent. No matter where you go in the world, if you hear a Beijing, somebody can know it's a Beijing, full stop.
And I think Jamaica is the most unique country, is because I don't think any other country in the Caribbean has left as big an impact on the world like Jamaica has.
Landscape in terms of places, the greenery in the country is not as much as other places, but like beaches and different places such as Cherry Tree Hill, the East Coast, Scotland District. it's real nice when you come here and you see these things. As I said, the language, amazing. It's supposed to be English, perfect English, but it's broken English. So we shorten everything to make it sound cool, and if it flows, it works.
And I think that my country is special because of, I don't know, how we relate to one another, you know, the jokes we do, and how we approach the difficulties in life.
In terms of the culture, I find the Asian culture, as of recent, is a mixture of European and American culture. We still have our own culture in terms of the whole Caribbean culture. I mean, from the roots of the West Africans, but I find we're trying to adapt more to the US, but that's all right. That's all right. Can't be bothered about it. In terms of how we dress, as I said, a lot of the American, European, whatever styling, whatever is trending in fashion, we wear.
I believe that my country is super unique in various aspects. For example, language or food, the culture, and I wouldn't say clothing, but as time progressed, we have adopted very modernized way of dressing.
And the culture of my country. I think that's my favorite thing about my country, the culture. Our culture is so rich. It's so full of traditions and influence from Europe and Africa and India, Italy. So that's why I love my country, and I invite you to go to my country someday. Cuba, that's the best country in the world.
From the music to the culture to our athletes worldwide, known worldwide. So that's why I think that we're the best.
Welcome back to The Lunch Bag. Thank you so much for staying with us. And now we'll head over to Chrisanne, who has an interesting feature on fast cars.
If you like fast cars like I do, then you will no doubt enjoy this feature. Well, I hope you enjoyed that feature as much as I did. Round that back to you on the main set.
Thank you, Chrisanne. So, we're going to join Tyreek, who's going to talk to a special guest about how the gentlemen can spice up their beard life. Tyreek?
Do you have trouble finding grooming products for your beard? Well, our next guest is someone who is here to give us some health beard care solutions just for you. Joining us on set is Mr. Jamie Martin, the Chief Executive Officer for Ruffian. Welcome, Mr. Martin.
Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me.
Right, so you have created a line of products for men's grooming. What inspired you to do so?
In my earlier years, I struggled with self-esteem and self-image issues until I started to grow my beard and take care of my beard. I realized that I really started feeling better about myself, and I spoke to some other males around me, and they agreed that when they grew out their beard, they felt better as well. So I decided that I would want to help men to improve and develop their self-image and self-esteem, and that's how Ruffian came about.
All right, thanks. All right, so tell us more about your brand and your product and the name that represents Ruffian.
Funny story about the name. It actually stems from the older generation around me actually neglecting beards and having a negative view of beards. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to change that perception. I wanted to be a ruffian against the thought of beards are not allowed in should not be allowed in the workplace, are not healthy, are not appealing. So that's really how the name came about.
And what you just said a while ago about beard not being welcome in and around the workplace, you are here to ensure that your beard is healthy and is well-groomed.
Definitely.
All right, so entrepreneurs have shared that establishing a successful business can be very difficult. How has your entrepreneurial journey has been thus far?
Wow, a lot of hills. A lot of valleys, but when you reach the hills, you feel good. And you know that there's a lot left to do and you can see the progress. So it's really inspiring for myself. I inspire myself through this business and I'm grateful for it.
That's awesome. That's awesome stuff. All right, so what advice do you, as an entrepreneur, have to adjust to during this COVID crisis?
Really just keeping customer engagements and increasing the customer database, even though we can't really meet with clients, meet with customers. We usually do a lot of shows, usually go to a lot of events and expos, but now because of that, you know, that's cut down. So it's really adjusting and finding a way to deliver the same experience, same product, same service to the customers.
And how can persons find you or your product?
You can follow us on Instagram, it's RVFFIAN_. You can check us out on One Shop, on Qmall, and you can just message me, Jamie Martin, yeah.
All right, so tell us more about the products and how can men use the products, or how should we use the products?
Okay, so the products are made from all natural ingredients, and what you do is, it's best to use it twice per day after you shower or wash your face. Okay. So, for instance, with the beard oil, you use roughly 2 to 3 drops. Mm-hmm. Just put it in your palm, massage your palms together, and massage it into the skin and in the hair. And afterwards, use the beard balm now to actually give the beard some hold and gets rid of any itching, moisturizer, and all that stuff.
Okay, so when you are using it, you use the oil first, then the
balm. Definitely.
All right, awesome stuff. I do hope you brought one for me because as you can see, my beard needs some work.
I'm here, man. I'm here for you.
Yes. Well, thank you so much for joining us here today, Mr. Martin, and for sharing your product. And men out there, if you are interested in grooming your beard or need some beard health care, per se, you can contact Mr. Martin at
_JVIME_. I won't give up my phone number just yet, but you can check me on Instagram.
All right, thank you so much for joining us here, Mr. Martin.
Thank you for having me.
We have a rather interesting take on mask wearing just for you, so check that out.
Hi, that's me, and you're probably wondering how I got here. So let me show you. So I've been spending a lot of time indoors and alone because of, you know, the COVID-19 pandemic. Quarantine, social distancing, and all of that. I've been doing school online, but today, I have an in-class presentation. My first physical interaction in weeks, and it's public speaking. Wow. But I'm ready for it. Or at least, well, I think I am. And now we're here. This corona and mask life is getting really out of hand. But I'd rather be annoyed, uncomfortable, and embarrassed than, you know, dead.
One. Well, that was our little take on masks. Guys, what do you think?
All right, so guys, I do feel the pain of my friend here. Even though we got some smoothies, and because of the mask, we cannot drink our smoothies.
Quite terrifying, don't you think?
I plan to drink mine.
Well, even though we are tired of the mask, we definitely need to wear our mask because COVID is still on the loose. We still need to protect ourselves. Mm-hmm. And in protecting ourselves, the mask protects me and protects you from COVID.
That's right.
And of course, before we go, I've got to leave you with an important tip from the jar. Here goes. Anything you love requires patience. Be patient with yourself and trust in your process.
It was really great to have you guys here on set with me, Chanel and Ralna, and you guys watching at home. And also, Kristen, how can I forget, or features yeah. from Kristen. Thank you so much for joining us here on set. Thank you guys for being here, and thank you at home for joining us here today.
We're looking forward to seeing you again next week, Friday, same time, same place.
Until then, take care, and remember, keep wearing your mask.
Yeah.